Hello everyone, I am Dr. Anshu. Today we will discuss about application for employment. An application for employment is a standard business document prepared by an employer just to find out the best capable person for a particular position. These types of documents and forms are prepared upon request. And later on, it becomes the responsibility of the candidate to fill in the complete form and return it to the employer for the consideration. The return document notifies the employer regarding the availability of the candidate, his desire to join the particular position, his qualification, his experience, his knowledge, background, etc. And it determines that particular person is appropriate for that particular position or a particular job. From the employer's perspective, the application serves a number of purposes. It depends upon the particular job for which a person is hired. Along with that, preferences that a person has decided, the person who is hiring someone. So we will discuss what are the various requirements of job application and how can we fulfill them so that we can be chosen as the best candidate for that particular suitable job. An application for employment, as I had already discussed, that it is often your first step. Employers use it to learn about your qualification and compare you to other applicants as well. And as per the information provided regarding your qualification, your experience, your exposure to various jobs, your life, your skills, your detailings, they compare it and they decide a suitable candidate who can fit for that particular suitable job. So while filling the applications, you need to follow certain directions. You need to avoid having your application rejected because you filled it out wrong. So this cannot be the reason, or this cannot be the appropriate criteria that you have not read the application or the directions given in the application appropriately, and that's why you were rejected. Read the entire application before you complete it and fill it properly and reread it, edit it. If required, proofread it. Pay close attention to what is being asked and how you are expected to respond. Do not write two sections that say, do not write below this line, or if it is written that this is for office use only. So you need to be observant and you should not write in those areas where you are not asked to write. Fill in the applications neatly and completely. This is the basic requirement because neatness is expected from a person who is applying for a particular job. Make sure that your applications create a good impression by answering all the employer's questions. Whatever the questions you are asked, you need to reply those questions up to the satisfactory level. Before you leave home, create a personal data sheet regarding your personal qualification, your experience, your exposure. They should include all the information you might need to complete an application, like name of previous employers, employment dates, addresses, telephone numbers, etc. So you should have all these detailings along with you once if you have decided to fill in any application. Most applicants will ask for references. So add this to your personal data sheet as well, that whom you could refer in your application. You need to write the details about the person whom you are whom you are giving the reference, his address, about his designation, and each and every detail, phone numbers, etc. So do not use abbreviations except for NA, that means not applicable. Otherwise, please do not use any abbreviations. Respond to all the questions. If a question does not apply to you, use NA to indicate that it is not applicable. This shows the employer that you did not overlook anything. And even if a question is not pertaining to you, or you are not willing to provide any information regarding that, even then you have written NA, that is not applicable to you. By filling out a paper application, you need to follow certain directions. Make a rough draft always and write out responses on a separate sheet of a paper before completing the real application. So always jot down the information on a rough sheet, or get two copies as use the first one as a rough draft and later on transfer the whole data into the application, so that it is written clearly, and use a black erasable pen and print it clearly on the application form. Proofread it again and again. Make sure that you have no grammar and spelling errors. If possible, have someone else review the application to catch errors you might miss. Keep it neat. Use corrections fluid to fix minor errors, but use it appropriately so that you can avoid certain errors that you may expect to commit in a paper application while you are filling it. List your desired position. This is also important. These are some expected general questions that are asked by you. So you need to prior decide your answers. What will you be answering for those certain questions? Do not leave this question blank or use any or open. You need to specify which is the desired position that you need to specify. If you are answering a job and are looking for a specific position under that job title, that is really necessary. Fill out more than one application if you are interested in more than one job. If you are not applying for a specific position under the name of the department in which you wish to work. So these are the specific specifications that you need to add on. And even the salary requirements are to be incorporated. Give a range for your salary requirements. Employers may use this question to screen out applicants. It is best to give a salary range or list negotiable if you wish to do so. Even if you know the wages, this leaves you room to negotiate a higher salary. Always you can write negotiable if you wish to write. Mention positive reasons for leaving past job. Even many a time you are asked that why did you leave the previous job. Choose your words carefully with the question, avoid using the words fired, quit, illness, personal reasons. Always use a positive statement. Here are some possible ways to handle this question. And you need to specify reasons for leaving. Left to devote more time to academics. Landed a higher paying job. Offered a new position from another company. Rather than, you need not to say that you got into a fight or any other adverse effect that may create. You need not to add on these types of experiences. So once, if you wish to talk about fire, do not use the term fired or terminated. Consider using involuntary separation. In spite of using fired, you can use involuntary separation. You may want to call past employers to find out what they will say in response to reference checks. When doing so, reintroduce yourself and explain that you are looking for a new job. Be honest that your termination hurts your chances of getting another job. Past employers will usually agree to use the term resigned. This response saved them potential headaches and even many other inconveniences that may be created to them as well. Now quit. If you quit your job, use the term resigned or voluntarily separated. These responses indicate that you followed proper procedures in leaving the job. If the application asks for a reason, then you can respond in the following manner. Quit for a better job. This can be an option. This reason includes living for advancement, potential to work closer to home, for a better work environment, or for a career change. If you quit for a better job, there should not be a long break in employment. Your employment history should support the statement, quit to move to another area. So if you are willing to move to some other area, even then, that particular reason can be notified. Quit to attend school. If you use this reason, the education listed on your application or resume must reflect it. Quit for another reason, such as took an extended vacation or any volunteer work or any personal business or any personal issue of your family, if you wish to notify, you can use it as well. Laid off from a job. If you are laid off from a job due to no fault of your own, indicate the reason for the layoff. There are some possible phrases that you can use. Lack of work, lack of operating funds, temporary employment, seasonal employment, company is closed, plant closing, company downsized, corporate merger, and many other reasons that can be notified. Present a positive, honest picture of yourself during your job search. The information that you provide is likely to become a part of your permanent employment record. So always provide true information, because false information can be the basis of dismissal. Official record showing that you have finished a training course or have a necessary skills. Include only those that meet the specific requirement of the job. Now here, many applicants have limited space to record your skills, experience and accomplishments. To decide what information to include, research the company. It is really necessary. Its products or services and the skills that are required for that particular job in that company. Attach a resume that details your skills and experiences and accomplishments required to that particular job. Now, target your qualification. Include only those that meet the specific requirement of the job. Many applications have limited space to record your skills, experiences, and accomplishments. To decide what information to include, research the company, its products or services, and skills needed for the job. Attach the resume that details your skills, experiences, and accomplishments so that whatever you wish to include, which is not asked in the particular application, you can include there. The upcoming session, we'll be discussing about connect with the captive audience. and even some more detailings are to be discussed in the upcoming session regarding the various types of job applications and the different types of requirements that are to be fulfilled in a job.